Hello, everyone. How you doing today? Whoa, I just realized all the ingredients are in front of the camera.
That's probably better.
Hello, hello. Wow, my hand is also very blue. That might be a medical issue that I need to fix. But hello, everyone. How's it going? I just feel like I have to shake off the dust after the weekend. Curried away. Hello, hello, hello. How's it going, guys? Two heart reach, asterisk again. Thank you for the mouse, the monitor, and the batteries. If you guys don't know, asterisk bought us a new monitor. A mouse for the streaming computer because we were using this old ancient optical mouse that kind of was janky on this quartz countertop, and batteries for the lav mic, which will hopefully get a new one sometime next week. I'm doing great, dude. Thank you again, Astris. You got the... Oh, Two Heart, you're good too? Cool. I didn't get any skins from my Overwatch box. And that's why I'm playing Overwatch music today. Because it's Overwatch's anniversary. If you guys didn't catch that already. Already. This is ridiculous. Also, Don got me this. It's a knife that I will use exclusively today. Right? Isn't it kind of scary? It's You know what? This is on Amazon. The name of it is Big Almighty Knife. It's a Tojiro Big Almighty Knife. It's so silly. Pretty sure Don got it for me as a joke. Or so he could experience his pain because he bought this knife too. Yeah, man, it's like... That's how long it is. But I'm gonna use it today. Just so I can say I've used it. Hello, Harry. Well, first we're gonna prep some rice. And then we're gonna get this... Cooking on... Roll. Right, exactly, Red. I'm detective. I'm sure. Hello, Helens. Sorry. Brick. I'm sure if someone is like, I'm gonna use this knife! Because I can! At least, I'd be more scared of it if it had a pointy tip, but it's a flat tip, so I'm not too scared of it. Yeah, that will definitely work out my, forearm. So I got some jasmine rice here that I'm making for our curry tonight. The broccoli everywhere is shuddering fear.
Fear me, green beans, and corn.
Chef Ellie's coming for you. All right, let me wash this up, and we'll get started on the chicken. So how was everyone's weekend? Did y'all have a good weekend this weekend? Cleaver's this, like, if it was heavier, I would assume it's a Cleaver Halo. You see me. Hi. But it's not really a Cleaver. I mean, it could be. And maybe I would, but like, I feel like this would be more for like, long slices. Like, if I had to cut through, like, roasts. But you could probably use this as a cleaver. You probably get more, like, speed out of the tip. Like, if you hit things with it. Like.
Pa!
But yeah, look, it's... Let me move this over a bit. Okay, so it's almost as big as my knife board. My cutting board. It's got maybe an inch left. So, we're gonna use it though. What are we gonna do here? Let's pull up this recipe and then get going, guys. I know, that's the one I pick up. That'll scare him for sure. That guy's crazy. He's got a huge freaking knife. Okay, so. totally chime in. Jason? Yeah, right. Okay, so we're gonna cut our chicken here into cubes. So silly. Oh my god, at least it's sharp, man. I'll tell you right now. I'm so amused. Diego, what's going on, dude? Yeah, right, the butcher's knife. This is gonna be a pain in the ass to sharpen. I'm sure. I'll probably take it to just a professional and be like, can you just sharpen this, please? Because my little stone is not going to cut it for this. Cut it. Ha, cut it. I guess when Don shows up here, I'll read his note. Because he wanted me to read his note on stream. You guys would get a trip out of that. Actually, let's switch up my playlist now. Something more we're used to here. Straight overkill, right? Giant knife hype. C- completely overkill for this. But I'm going to use it today. Because I was given this knife. And I will use it for at least one day. On stream. I could first see myself like cutting through bones with this thing. Like if I ever use like whole chicken. Like if I need to like split a whole chicken in half. I could use this, right? This would work. Like, here, I posted a picture. I can show you guys. This is the knife I use normally, right? This is normal. This is the knife I have right now. I like this knife. This is crazy. For a sawing team? Yeah. I cut down some lumber for the fire, guys. Alright, so my chicken's cut. Giant's meal, yeah. Should. Okay, let's see here. What do I need to do other than that? Because everything else is pretty simple for this recipe. I think I'm gonna cut some onion just because I'd like it in my recipe. Hey, Lemon, what's going on? Open our bag of onions here. Good. I just need one onion. I feel like Martin Yan. Yan, you know who Martin Yan is? He loves his cleavers. And he's like, he does all sorts of like intricate stuff with a cleaver. I'm like, ugh. Martin, you don't need a cleaver. Anyway, so we're gonna cut this onion. The ridiculousness of this. It's not lost on me. He is awesome. But he loves his cleavers, man. He's like doing like intricate designs with a cleaver on an apple. I'm like, bro. Come on, man. That's what the smaller knives are for. You're gonna kill yourself. Ashes, thank you for the host. Oh yeah, he was on PBS a long time too. Let's see here, let's just slice this. That's nice though. We'll admit, that's kind of nice. Except it's all sticking to the knife. Oh, yeah, that's right. Cut out a face on the onion. No thanks. Not this time. That crunch. Hey, Ace. What's going on? I probably won't even use all this, I'm just cutting with it. Okay. I know, right? It's so shiny. It's still got the mirror finish on it, so you can see, like, my light fixtures that aren't on. And then you can see my face somewhere. Wait, can you see my face? I'll try it again. Hello, it me. Alright, so things we're gonna use in this recipe. We're gonna use lime zest. We have ourselves here some green curry paste. We've got ourselves some bamboo shoots. We've got ourselves some... Actually, do I need this? Just some sort of oil. So sesame oil or coconut oil would work. The banjo music. Oh, I need bell peppers. Or just a single bell pepper. I have to cut this. Yes, another thing to cut, guys. I'm gonna wash this up. Alright. The banjo music. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and just, you know, let's see here. Let's do it this way. Ooh. Ooh, yeah. Wow. That was, surprisingly satisfying. Alright, that's good. The monstrosity. So we're just gonna cut this into strips. Should I do it the other way? I think so. I'll do it this way. Just cut that into a strip there. Cut this in half. Should I cut it like this way? Let's do it that way. So unnecessarily long. Keeping my fingers way away from it because I'm so scared of it right now. It's extra sharp too, because it's fresh. Alright. You're scared just watching me cut with it? Yeah. At least, like, there's a range where I can move it. Juan Mata, what's up? What's going on? Whole duck, hey, Reddit, Reddit detective. If you're gonna cut a whole duck, you should probably, here, just take this, please. Just take this knife from me. I'm not gonna need it for the whole duck. Like, it's probably easier for you to cut with it, so. Here, just take it. Ooh. That was close. Actually, did I? I did. I just tapped it and I cut myself. Thanks, Rifle. All right. Well then. That was fun for like a quick second. I know, right? Don't jinx me, all right? Don't jinx me. Giant knife. I like this thing. This is overkill. All right. Hey, what's up, Jan? Specialist 7. What's going on? Okay. I'm a little fiery. I'm also gonna rinse this real quick. Dude, that like didn't even hurt. It like touched the knife. I was like, did I cut through my skin? I did cut through my skin. Cool. All right, so we've got a wok over here. Yes, the monitor is definitely more appropriately sized. It's perfect, actually. Yep, we've got a wok over here. I'm heating it up right now. First, we're gonna start off with a little bit of oil. Got some coconut oil over here that we're gonna add to the pan. Right underneath the shotgun. Dude, like, for real, detective? That's... Those things are scary too, man. I already cut myself with it, Don. Okay, so since Don is here, I'll read the note that he has sent me. Here. Hi, the Hunger Service, aka LA. Fuck you. P.S. I want to say hi to myself so that when you put this note on stream, I can say what's up to myself. Yeah, I kind of touched my finger right here, and then it like kind of nicked me. I barely cut myself. That's okay. Yeah, dude, it's surprisingly sharp. That's why it didn't even hurt. I like looked at my finger, I was like, oh, it's like I cut myself. It was like so matter-of-factly, I was like, all right. Yeah, right, this thing. No joke. I don't even know where I'm gonna put it, Don. It doesn't fit in any of my drawers. Actually, it might. It might. It'll fit in this drawer, but I need space for it. Oh, Japanese steel, yeah. So sharp. Hey, Cosmic, what's going on? What's the matter, Aced? How much DPS is this knife? I don't know. It's slower attack speed than this knife, but I feel like it's a little bit more DPS than this one. Got maybe like one or two hits ahead. I heard it. I didn't have
no remorse.
I didn't have enough dex to wield it yet. Oh yeah, it's a sapping weapon for damage. Face cam is a little low. Hey, Issa. Conan the Barbarian. Okay, so we're gonna
hold on, let me open this up real quick. Comes like this. So,
I'll show you what's up. Call up MegaCon, no.
Isn't that your shooting finger?
Like, trigger finger. That's okay. It'll heal quickly. Okay, so, I bought this. It's green curry paste. And it comes in this tub, but what you don't know, it also comes in this. Now, this is green curry paste, okay? And if you're gonna work with curries, you're gonna find these pretty often. So, don't be alarmed. Don't be alarmed by it. What I usually do is I just pour it back into the tub. Hey, Undead, what's going on? What?
Just waiting for you to cut yourself again.
I need a place to store this knife. I might store it in here, like flat. Or in the other one, flat. Doing well, dude.
Stick it on the fridge with a magnet.
What? Stick it on the fridge with a magnet? Put it in the box? Yeah, you're right. Okay, green curry. This is the paste that is usually associated with it. Put it in the tub. Use it as we go. But they put it in this bag for shipping and transport. So you just put it in the tub when you're ready to start using it. I'll probably use it pretty often in the next couple weeks. Put it on a lanyard to hang it off my spine. I'm gonna need a sheath. We're making green, Thai green curry chicken today, Frightful. Or who asked? Zombie. No, wait, who asked? I just saw someone ask if it was Undead, sorry. I really like red curry. I don't have green curry too often, so I don't even remember if I'm a huge fan of it, but I'll have it. I mean, I'll still eat it. Yeah, I love red curry. I actually have a tub of red curry in the fridge for whenever I have like a craving for it. Anyway, we're gonna start with a couple tablespoons. No, maybe 3 or 4 tablespoons, because we're doubling this recipe, of green curry paste. We're gonna kind of saute it down with a little bit of onions. Alright, green curry paste. So I'm gonna take some of our onions here. Hey, organic, what's going on? I'm gonna start with, I do 4 tablespoons of green curry paste. Hey, Devin, what's going on? Oh, that's spicy. Man, that hit me right in the nose. How's it going, organic? I'm gonna cook this down a bit. Right now we're gonna add a little bit more oil and our chicken. Oh yeah? How's it been going? Why? I'm not worried about it. So we're just gonna... Oh man! Some potent curry paste, man. Ooh. So we're gonna brown our chicken and then coat it in our green curry paste here. Gonna lay it in one layer and then just let it cook down a bit. Day's been good, man. Just having a good cooking dinner, that's all. Spice your ground beef perfectly last night. Ooh. Oh man, that is really spicy. Ah. You like your burrito spicy? Had to add some heat. Okay. What'd you add to it to add heat? Okay, I need to prep my bamboo shoots here. Yeah. Let's sleep at 6. Alright, I got my bamboo shoots here. Oh. So I just got some shredded bamboo shoots. Tapatio? Yeah. Solid. Ton of Tabasco. We're just flipping our chicken over a bit, and then we're gonna add our coconut milk. So I've got solid amount of coconut milk here. Just a can of 13.5 ounces. Use the entire thing because I like it a little saucy anyway. Vinegary hot sauces? Hey Pablo, what's up?
Oh, it's still spicy.
Oh. Straight to the nose, guys. And we're gonna cut this with a little bit of water.
Base of spices. This one's
a cilantro based, I believe. Cholula? Oh, I love Cholula. Tabasco? I'm like 50-50 on Tabasco. Might be too vinegary for me. So I'm just gonna bring this back up to a boil. And then we're gonna add our bamboo shoots. We're gonna zest this lime. And then we're gonna cover it. It was in there. Excuse me. No, like it's literally from this. No, earlier today I had the last bit of kimchi from a bottle. And
are you sure?
Question mark. A bottle. And the thing about the bottom of the kimchi bottle is that it's the spiciest part. So, like, just picked it up and just ate it, and, like, I got, like, 2 bites in before I was like... Okay, coming up to a boil now. I really don't like those chef's hats. They won't fit my head.
It'll fit your head. It's quite large.
But they're gonna cut right here.
Don't wear one every day. You lose feeling in your head.
That's all I don't want.
It makes the day go by better.
Oh, you really can't see the color in that. It's like got a like a yellow green color right now. Yep. Hold on, let me adjust this camera. Hopefully I can do it right. Oh, forget it. I can't adjust it. Alright. So to this, right now, we're going to add a little bit of our bamboo shoots, probably just half a cup. And then all our bell pepper. Zest. What? What?
I think that's the wrong way.
Oh, sorry, why? You don't go too low on, or too deep on the zest, or else you're gonna get pith. And the pith's all bitter, you don't want that. It'll really pith you off. Actually, I don't think I got far enough on my lime here. Hold on. I'm like half scared I'm gonna drop it in there. Hi, Beth.
Beth?
Yep.
It's Beth. Beth.
Okay, so from here, we're gonna cover it and let it sit for 10 minutes. Crass. La Croix. What's the craziest thing you've ever put into curry? I don't know. Cosmic was like the D. I don't want Rocky Mountain oysters though, undead. I don't think I would ever do the thing for that. I don't know. I don't think I've done anything crazy with curries before. I've had mussels in curries.
You should put tuna in cake.
Tuna in cake. This doesn't even hurt. It just like.
You're so delicate. You must be Italian.
It's not about what you put in the curry, but what the curry puts in you. What is the curry putting in me? Yes, it is, let's see here. Some sort of...
What?
Yeah. It's a little bit of oil. There's also shrimp paste in here, which probably consists of the oil that they use, the fats they use to hold it all together. If you've never had shrimp paste before, that's a thing. That's a thing in Thai cooking and Filipino cooking. Lots of Asian cooking. So we're just letting it cook down a bit. I'm turning it down just in case. Looks like it's cooking faster than I want it to. I'm gonna give it a little stir, just in case. Palabok.
I really want to make palabok.
But that smell coming from it is really nice right now. You want to smell it? Store away these bamboo shoots. I don't know what I'm going to do with these. We'll probably make something out of them.
Some point.
Stir fry. Yeah.
Oyster sauce.
Oyster sauce? I might put it in the okonomiyaki. Okonomiyaki. You've had it before, I don't think you really care for it. It's the cabbage pancake thing that Alan used to make.
Make Asian tacos. Use that instead of like cabbage.
Yeah, I cut myself. Green chicken curry! Or is it green curry chicken? Because it'd be weird if the chicken was green. At which point we shouldn't eat the chicken. I did, because I was playing with this. Hi, Anna. Chicken curry green. Wait, hold on. What kind of green are we talking about here, Cosmic? It's still cooking really fast. It needs to calm down.
You need to calm down.
No, you need to calm down. Green eggs and ham. You need more fondant?
Yeah. Everything's died. Oh no, I bought some.
Hey, Pud. All I'm using is OBS, PUD. And I just have them in separate sources. Your favorite food? I'm looking forward to having some right now, because I'm really hungry. I do. I will be posting it probably on Discord. Don't eat the yellow snow. Ugh. Well, it's not coming out as green as I was hoping for, but maybe I need more curry paste. I'm gonna give it a taste, just to make sure that I am not messing this up.
It'll look green to me.
It looks very yellow right now.
I'm also colorblind.
Oh, that's spicy. Oh, that's spicy. It's really good though. I think it just needs time to cook down.
To get spicier?
Oh, dude. This is spicier than the red curry. Yes, this is Chris. Aw, Anna. Cosmic's like, I've never seen them on stream before.
I will cut you with that.
Oh, I messed it up. Oh, hello. What are you gonna do with your fondant?
Make it
fondant. It's so good. It's It's so spicy. True Gamer, what's up, dude? What's going on? So after this, we're gonna add some fish sauce. We're gonna add some sugar. And I need some Thai basil. Hey, Pud. Cooking potatoes. Got myself some Thai basil here. Ganymede. I think I might have overdone it. I don't think I need this much, but it's okay. Out some leaves here. I just need like a third of a cup. Ganymede needs a bigger pan. No, it's a pun. Oh, oops. I'm like half reading chat and half focusing here. I'm sorry. Alright, I think that's enough. Focusing is for weenies. You're a weenie! yeah, don't you have to, you know, finish those before next weekend? Alright, I'm gonna do a little taste test here. Done this test. I'm using chicken thighs as usual, but chicken breast is more than fine. Mmm. It's good. Hey, Sky. Oh, man, it's spicy. Anna, if you're in here, this is so much more spicy than I'm used to. What?
Incorrect grammar.
Spicier?
I'm saying your mother's a teacher, but she's used to that.
There's no ginger. I didn't put ginger in here. What?
Gin.
Asadu. Noodle, hello! What, Nifty? What? What's BDO? BDO games?
I
Well, thank you, Noodle. What? It's Kenan and D. Black Desert Online? Not familiar. Okay, so from here, we're gonna add about a tablespoon of fish sauce. I use curry paste too. I feel like the ingredients can be potentially hard to work or find. So paste, I feel like paste is acceptable. You could buy all the ingredients and then blitz everything down. I don't have that ability yet because I don't have a proper food processor. But you need fish paste, you need... Let's see here, wait, what else did you need here? That's pretty much shrimp paste and a lot of different spices. Not too bad, but... this is a simple way to cook it. The lazy way, if you will. But I feel like the results are comparable to if you make it straight up. Alright, we're gonna add a little bit of sugar. Maybe just a tablespoon. Last but not least, we're going to add our basil leaves. Whole. You could cut them up, but I kind of like it like this. I saw that. Yeah, Noodle. That's what I say. Try to make this as accessible as possible. So that people would be willing to try it. But if you want to get really fancy, you can look up a green curry paste and make it on your own. But this is pretty simple on its own. What's missing mushrooms? Smang it. Now you can't stop saying it. Now you're done. You keep thinking about smanging it. Real hoity-toity like. All right, I'm gonna clean up a bit. I added lime zest.
Because we didn't have any kefir lime leaves, and I can't find them for the life of me. Do you know where you can get kefir lime?
Yeah, Target.
You guys have it at Target?
Of course.
What?
Of course, I'm fucking.
Oh, okay.
I don't know.
Hey, Angela. I'm just cleaning up a little bit here. No, not anymore, Noodle. I used to be a sushi chef. But,
kept cutting himself.
No, I didn't keep cutting myself.
But,
you couldn't cut it.
Hey, Ad. Ad Nalor. Hello. But I gave it up. Because I'm also a professional photographer. And that's what I do for work nowadays. So now I just cook at home a lot because I'm home a lot. So that gives me lots of time to learn new dishes, practice my old dishes. I almost went into culinary, but I decided against it. The cooking lifestyle is a difficult one. Cool. You have any dishes that you, do you have any favorite dishes, Noodle? Or like, what about your go-to dishes? That's a good question. I like knowing everyone's go-to dishes. Hey, what the heck? I didn't know you had access to that, command, Pud, so I'm gonna have to fix that. Cereal, my go-to dish. Chinese food, ooh. Soy sauce and rice, shut up, Don. Because he doesn't know how to cook. That's what Don said.
Is he coming or not?
Are you coming, Don?
To visit.
That's funny. Oh, let me fix that. Water. There we go. Don's like, I'm coming. Whispers. Lena! Thank you for the follow. I'm gonna turn this down all the way. I think we're good. But I'm gonna give it a taste, make sure that we're good here. Affrittata.
Affrittata?
Where? Sounds like Chris knows Don. Yeah, we all went to college together.
I don't know what you're talking about. Get out of my house.
Whoa. I'm gonna need to cut that with some rice, man. That's hardcore.
I wanna see you cut something with rice.
Is that a can of clam chowder? No, it's Thai green curry chicken.
This is a can of progressive loaded potato.
Get out of here. Hey, Glow! I'm putting it over rice today. Oh, and thanks. Alicia made this for me. So it's fancy. I'm familiar with it, Pud. I feel like I shouldn't make it at some point. I did make jasmine rice for this, actually. Yeah, at some point. I have a schedule that I put out every Monday. So, Monday I'll be posting next week's schedule. I don't know what I'm making yet. But I actually want to get going on making another week. Because this week's kind of crazy. I have MegaCon this coming Friday, Saturday, Sunday. So,
it's gonna be interesting.
Multiple camera angles. I'm like kind of still cooking it to let it thicken up a bit. But yeah, I could definitely teach next time. I want to make Dinuguan first. Cause that's something like I only get once or twice a year. And that'd be something I'd love to make. But soon. What? No? Please let me guess. Alright, I will wait until you're available to be here, Beth. And then I will make Dinuguan.
You know what it is?
Yeah.
Okay.
Beth's half Filipino. So,
I am?
Yes. Well, she was raised with Filipinos, so.
So she's a dean.
She's the dean, yeah.
She's a fucking black guy.
Okay.
Alright, let's grab a bowl here. Actually, the bowl I want is dirty, so I'm gonna wash it real quick.
Indoctrinated, she says. All right, I'm gonna grab some rice here.
Actually, let me grab my other camera too. Oops.
Okay, so that's not your camera.
Oopsies.
No means no, LA. Ugh. Actually, no. Hold on. Where's your camera down here?
Sweet!
For the
do you have fresher bagels? I know. I don't know where the bottom of this thing is.
Your mom just left for the Philippines?
Oh.
It's been more than a decade for me.
Since I've been to the Philippines. Knocking cameras. All right, guys, hold on.
I'm here. Let's see if I can get this to work correctly. There it is. Okay, so we got our bowl of rice.
Yeah.
I forgot what song this is.
Bolero?
Is it Bolero? Oh yeah? Yeah, I don't go very often either. Let's see here. Let me twist it. And maybe focus in on it again. Are you hungry, Chris? Could you go for more?
Soup?
This.
It's still spicy.
It's pretty spicy.
Better than the red one?
It's pretty freaking spicy. Could be.
Remember when Don ate that whole chili?
And you didn't?
Yeah. Don, do you remember that? Is he still there?
I don't know if he's still there. Eh, there you go. Really simple dish. We got our bamboo shoots, our bell peppers, our chicken. What chili? Quagmire, hello! The one from the pho place, when you all went. Pho hua.
Why is your face on the pho? Oh, just,
sorry. Here, you can look at it.
Got you.
Give me a hug. He's like, oh yeah, that shit was spicy. Well, thank you, Zombie. I'll take that as a compliment. But hello, Quagmire. Welcome to the Hunger Service. Thanks for the follow.
It did rain.
It rained really hard for the past 2 days. It's been raining here a lot. It rained last night. You slept. You slept through it.
I woke up to get to work.
I'm gonna have to take a picture of this real quick.
Feel free to grab a bowl of rice.
If you so desire.
Hey, put it back!
Can you take a picture?
You said the bowl of rice?
Just doing what I was told.
Wait, where do you live again, Ad? If you don't mind me asking. Mini heat wave? We've been the opposite. Like, we were in a drought up until... We didn't have rain here for a month and a half.
Is this noticeably green?
No.
Okay.
Yeah, don't worry.
Like, are you fucking with me right now?
No, it's not... Oh. You're in California too. Cool. Yeah. I'm putting Don's knife in the background.
Did you use it to cut anything other than yourself?
Yeah, I cut the chicken and the vegetables. Cool. Hey Don, maybe I'll make this the logo of the Hunger Service. Yeah, I know. It's been really hot here for the past month. Like mid-90s. But today and yesterday, it's been, like, downpouring, so it's kind of nice. Well, it stopped, but it, like, rained really hard earlier.
I didn't notice it rained yesterday at all.
Yeah. There you go. I'm not sure if it was the kind of coconut milk I used. Or if I put too much coconut milk, but it's definitely not as green as I was thinking it was gonna come out to be.
Well, same thing happens when you make the red curry.
Yeah, the red curry comes out like nice and yellow orange.
That's not how bento looks.
Yeah.
It's just like watery, but like spicy as fuck. Licky. Don't do it.
How many feet above sea level? Not enough. Enough to be scared of climate change. Couple drops of green food. I don't want to cheat too much, Chopper. Though that would be an easy way to make it green. That's okay.
Green? Super green?
Super green. I'll take care of that after this. Add kale. You know, I do have kale, Dr. Devin, but I don't think I want to add kale to this. Coconut cream. Kale is gross. Kale belongs in the trash can.
True story.
I like roasted kale. Like kale chips, pretty much. Kale chips are delicious. I'll give them that.
Let's give them all the kale back.
There's definitely still some Biko left. Actually, I might make another. I'm going to take everything out in a bit. Just put it on top. Use a box.
Do you need any of the boxes? No. Oh, dude.
Alright, I've used this knife. I'm gonna put it away for now. I'll try not to cut myself again. Yeah, there's still plenty of you. I might make another batch. Actually, I might make some now. Because I might give some to my dad before he leaves. So my dad's in town. But he's off with his cousin at the at Universal right now. Fonty Fanta. And considering how short this stream is running right now, I might make more on the fly. If that's cool with you guys, I'm gonna make more Biko.
Make it different.
Make it different. How?
I don't know. That was my idea.
Oh.
That's as far as it went.
Longer.
Skate better.
Did you have something?
Brink? You know, did you ever see Brink?
Yes. The cool. Disney movie?
Yeah. It's yeah. The quote from Brink.
Hmm. I'm gonna dive into this though. So I've already taken a picture of it, so I'm gonna destroy it. Are we playing Overwatch later, Beth?
Beth, go take a shower now so we can play whole time.
Mmm. Oh, that spice is good though. Dude, you need to try this. I guess your nickname's Crass from now on. Crass.
Did you say I'm Crass?
Oh. I'm not
Crass.
The chicken's
in that voice though.
What? Oh. More food, please? Hey Raka, what's going on? If you're in here, I understand why you really like this. It's really good. Mm-hmm. It's got a fantastic depth of flavor. I really love it. Not of just green curry paste. I'm glad I got so much coconut milk because I feel like I'm gonna run through that. I might make some more later this week. Normally when I go to conventions I like packing lunch, so this might be something I pack. Later, Beth.
You're that person in the workplace that microwaves the food and stinks the whole office.
Stinks the whole office of delicious.
This thing's curry smells good in the middle of the day.
Curry's always delicious, shut up. I'm not the one. I'm not the person that like warms up like tuna casserole in the microwave. Ugh. No, it's not.
For the senses?
Oh.
What was the knife was in this?
Don! Yeah, the knife was in that.
What did Don say? Was it mean? Was it at least funny?
What if the office is full of Indians?
Is this like... legit curry, because then they'd be offended.
It's like Thai curry. It's Thai curry.
This shit came from a tub. Mm.
It's a good spicy too, Anna. You usually have it really spicy, Anna, because man, it's potent. It's a good potent, but it's potent.
Oh.
You eat it milder? The original recipe I had for this called for like actual spicy red chilies in it. And I was like, no, I'm gonna do bell peppers. Bell peppers are fine. Yeah, that's what I'm saying, zombie. There's some recipes that call for jalapeno on top of the curry paste. Mmm. You're actually a goat, Devin? Hey. Oh, man. You actually started liking Thai green curry after stumbling upon a restaurant? Cool. Yeah, those little Thai chilies, man, zombie. I think I put like two chopped up in pad Thai one time. That was a mistake.
Ow.
That's what I'm getting from it, Anna. There's like so many different flavors that I'm eating from it. It's like, yeah, that's right, Ashes. Actually, when we went to a Thai restaurant here in Orlando, they have four different spice levels. Mild, medium, hot, and Thai hot. And Alicia's like, oh, that sounds scary. I'll just do medium. When she got it, it was still spicy as all hell. So we had to make extra batches of fried rice to mix in with it. So that it was like palatable.
Was that the purple orchid place?
No. Sea Tai.
This was good. I went there once.
Yeah, for sure, Anna. That's definitely probably where it came from. Definitely probably. That's probably where it came from. What the heck, Chopper? I am not scared of that. I don't understand it, actually. I don't... You know, that's not a thing that happens. Mm-hmm. Fiery poops.
He's only scared of loud noises.
It's good. Rambo, hello. Organic. Yeah. Thank you. Oh, you can throw it in the fridge too, please. Yeah, moderation is nice. Like, I don't like too much spice because I still want to be able to taste my food. But, yeah, spicy's good though. When I first got to college, man, I could barely take like, barely have dots of sriracha in my food. And I'm gonna have to make it on larger batches. You like it?
I like that red one better.
You like red one better? I tried the bamboo shoots. Chinese chili oil and a greasy egg roll. Oh. Chili oil. Too good. What's it base? It's base, turmeric.
Tamarind.
When I was a kid, pepperoni was too spicy. Oh man, Devin. I think everything's too spicy when you're a kid.
You ever heard of a geographical tongue?
Geographical tongue? Or different places have different spice levels,
kind of sort of. But like, they're like any level of spice is like super spicy. One of my bosses has that, so she can't even have like the spicy Doritos.
Spicy Doritos? Huh, interesting. Yeah, chili oil is kind of like a back of the palate kind of spice. Not so much like a. Like to the live spicy. Oh man, zombie. Thanks for looking that up. Tamarind chutney? I don't think I've ever had that organic.
You should make chutney.
Chutney in general?
Yes. And then you can make all the shit that you put chutney on.
Like what?
I don't know. Look at chutney.
I need more of this. More.
Will it be safer?
Yeah. Shh, Alicia doesn't need to know there's onions in it. Actually, the original recipe didn't even call for onions. I was just like, I think I want onions in this.
You should put mushrooms though.
Mushrooms? Could've.
Carrots? Do you like carrots in your curry?
Yeah, I do like carrots. What is the weirdest thing you put in curry? Because now I keep thinking back to that question here earlier. Asparagus. Asparagus in curry?
I don't think it'd be good.
tamarind chutney, mint and tamarind chutney separately. Huh.
Pepperoni
and curry? Yeah, I don't know about that. All those spices just mixing with each other? Mm-mm. Oh, chicken pakoras? Oh, man. I love chicken pakoras. Ooh, that looks awesome. Alicia's a big fan of Indian food. And she loves curries. So, I actually think one of the first, not one of the first, one of the few recipes that I learned specifically for Alicia was chicken makhani. She doesn't eat grits anymore.
That's nice.
Oh, that's fantastic. Oh, butter chicken's so good. That's another one of my go-to recipes. That's fantastic. What? All right, hold on. Ooh, peri peri chicken?
Yeah.
I'm very much okay with peri peri chicken. Take care, Ad. I'll see you later. Thanks for stopping by. I'm making Alicia her bowl now. Oops, messed that one up. Do you have a link, Raka? Because I'd be willing to try it. Chicken Makani is butter chicken, for sure. Organic. I don't know if I addressed that. But yeah, those are definitely the same thing. There's so many different ways to make Indian dishes, too. So, because of all, like, regional differences. It's kind of like Filipino food, really. Because there's so many different ways to make Filipino food. Yeah, for sure, organic. Oh man, that's spicy.
It's so good.
So let's see here. Alright, so we're gonna start with a can of coconut cream. Because for the Biko stream, I definitely overbought. So I feel like I'll just make it for you guys again. Make it for my parents. And yeah. All right, so this is gonna get cooked down for a bit. It's gonna be a little bit. But this is the first time I've used this setup before. So it's gonna be interesting. I've never done one dish and had it set here while I work on another dish. So if you weren't around on Sunday for this stream, what I'm doing is I'm cooking down coconut cream. What's gonna happen is the coconut oil and the coconut solids are gonna separate, and we're gonna start frying up the coconut solids so that they're toasty. It's weird when you're staring from over there. So I have my burner set to medium high.
I've been here the whole time.
I know, it's just weird when I look over and you're just like... Well, what sort of meetings did you have today, Allure? What's been going on? I feel like I've been away from the stream for a while. I don't know why. Even though, like, I just streamed on, like, Sunday.
Is your thermometer
canted upward?
Tilted, like, to the side, or is it just kind of angled?
Angled. It's pretty level. As far as I can tell. But yeah. This should start separating faster today because I'm not so afraid of burning it as I was yesterday. Sunday. Thank you. But tomorrow should be interesting. I don't know if any of you have had okonomiyaki before, but I think it's an interesting dish that I don't think a lot of people have had before. I mean, I've never been to Japan, but I hear it's delicious. But I've had it in the States. I don't know how it compares to the Japanese equivalent. Not equivalent, was it? The Japanese...
Sorry, I don't know what?
Version? Have you ever had okonomiyaki before, Allure? If you're there? I got a piece of the can in there, like the can wrapper, not the metal part, but the wrapper on the outside. So you want to keep stirring it. Raka. Oh, you've had it before? Yeah, I'm making it tomorrow, dude. Or at least try to do it some sort of justice here. You really liked it?
What was that omelet thing you and Don made?
Which one?
The omelet thingy that like split open.
Oh, omu rice?
Yeah.
I should make that again. I don't think I've done that on stream. Thanks, Raka. English trifle?
No, a French trifle.
Beef sautéed with peas.
Lady
fingers. Yeah. I've got Japanese mayo with me, so it's not as thick and tangy as your typical mayonnaise. And I'm gonna make my own okonomiyaki sauce. So, I'm excited to do that too. I just need to find, the only thing I'm missing right now is bonito flakes. I don't have any. I'm gonna need to find some, hopefully tomorrow. It's the place I normally go to buy all my Asian ingredients. They didn't have any. Japanese mayo is better. It's like creamier and less fatty. It's really good. It added a little bit, but doesn't make the dish. Yeah, that makes sense. I feel like it's definitely more of a presentation than anything. It's kind of like how it's on top of takoyaki. They put it on top of takoyaki. Even though it doesn't really add too much to the dish, it's just nice to have. That's another thing I want to make, takoyaki. We need a cake ball maker.
Oh, that was those things?
for not cake balls, just takoyaki. Oh my gosh, Raka. That sounds like pain. Hot takoyaki especially. Cause it's kind of like a juicy-ish in the middle. Oh. Because of the octopus. I can imagine that hurt a lot. Amaretto chocolate sauce.
Yeah.
I'm not making that.
But I think it's right now.
Oh.
You should make desserts.
Pretentious desserts.
That's your job.
I just make cake
Those are pretentious. Coconut milk. Anna, we're here on Sunday. I made this coconut sticky rice. It's a Filipino dish. But I definitely overbought for it because I thought I'd use more than one batch. So now I'm just making another batch because my dad's in town with his cousin and his cousin's family. And they're going to Universal, so I feel like I'm going to send home some Biko with them. Even though my mom knows how to make it. My mom's not with them because she's a teacher, so she's at home. And of course my mom sent up food with my dad to give to me, so I feel like I should return the favor for once. What?
I keep looking at me, it's weird. I'm not doing it.
Like that?
Yep. I mean, you can look at what you're doing.
I realized that I'm like off camera at some point over there when I'm over here. There you go. Alright, this is starting to separate. Starting to thicken up. Hey, you need to calm down. There you go. Actually, Anna, this is coconut cream, not coconut milk. Devin, it's coconut cream. Don't be naughty. So we're gonna separate the oils from the solids here. We're gonna toast up the solids for our dish. So that's why we're cooking it down right now.
You have to strain it?
Yeah, I have to strain it at the end. No. Don't use my bare hands. I'm gonna let it cook down at medium high right now. So let it sit while I work on something here. Devin!
You know, if you're ever stranded, you could use your sock as a sieve.
Never aware of that.
Can you make an entire cake of
this book? I don't know. Maybe.
I'm always doing like the little ball thing.
I'm gonna calm it down a bit here. Hold on. I don't want it to cook too fast. But I needed to get to this point faster because the last time we did it, it took a really long time. Oh, coconut rice? Yeah. I have a Jamaican friend that does it, and he also adds like pineapple in it sometimes. Have you cooked for Dean?
I made him a fucking wolf cake.
This was in Gainesville. When he cooked. He cooked for all of us. What the heck?
Shut up.
Alright, slowly starting to thicken up. Devin! Devin, Twitch is not your Tinder. Go out there and meet someone, Devin. Don't bother Anna. Unless she wants to be bothered. And don't mind me. Hey Brian, I'm making Biko again. We don't have any pie pans up there? I thought we had like two.
Oh my god, look down.
Oh, fucking hell. Thanks. Scientist.
I suppose we had
pie pans. Yeah, cool. Sorry. Thank you. Wait, do you need these?
No, I don't remember buying them, so.
Okay.
Watch, tomorrow I'm gonna need them for
something. Son of a biscuit! Wait, what? I don't know if I missed something.
Why is it so beautiful?
Oh, God.
You idiot.
You scared the fuck out of me, Don.
You're dumb. I'm probably just trolling you.
You never know, man. I like to think, like 50% of the time, I just gambled the wrong way today.
Not your
cabbages. Not my cabbages.
How was that?
Hmm?
Did you make those?
No. My mom sent them up with my dad.
Oh, you came by already?
No. I went to see them.
Whatever, same thing. I mean, you saw them already. That's why then.
I blew his cover, he says. Hey man, we're just concerned, okay? I was like, that's why I asked Chris. I was like, yeah. Do you know anything about this dude?
I like hanging out with Annie.
Huh?
I like hanging out with Annie.
Yeah.
Oh!
How do you read that? You're so
I'm making more Biko, Alicia. I'm gonna send it home with my dad.
Go to bed at a decent hour tonight, will you?
Right, it really does look like melted marshmallow. Yeah, my dad went to Universal. He said, ha ha ha, me too, Chris. That's what Don said. He likes hanging out with Annie too.
Oh, yeah. So are they coming this week?
Hey! Don, you're still coming over, right?
I need to know, because I need to know.
Yeah, because I need to tell Alicia.
Why do you need to tell Alicia?
She needs to know, too. She needs to... We need to put up all the soundproofing. Looks like white pancake batter. Yeah, it's got like a melted marshmallow consistency right now.
That was my thing.
Yeah. I said it last time I was on.
Did you? I didn't
watch. Yeah, no, you didn't.
Lighting away.
Thanks. Alicia, your food's ready, by the way. If you're hungry. Hey, Papa, what's going on? We are almost to separation here. It's like really close right now. I feel like I'm gonna let it sit and see what happens this time. Because last time it turned into tiny, tiny bits. And maybe I want to try and go for something a little more solid. But we're going to see how it turns out. Panna cotta? Soundproof your room from the snoring? Coconut cream, yeah. Thanks, Devin. It's slowly solidifying. I feel like I slowed it down too much, though. So, I'm gonna pump it up a little bit. Hopefully catch up. Starting to toast up. You're starting to see bits in there. I'm starting to see oil separation now. Flip it like a physics! Hey man, what's going on? And hello, autosave, welcome to the Hunger Service. How are you doing today? I believe I've seen you here before. But correct me if I'm wrong. Try to remember everyone that stops by. Or at least see if I remember their name. Like, remember if I've seen their name before. Cool. Welcome. You caught me on like a second part of my stream. We made this earlier. It's a Thai green curry chicken. And now I'm just making dessert because I had extra ingredients from my Sunday stream. So I'm cooking down this coconut cream so that the solids and oils separate and get this nice toasty bits of coconut. Polish. I don't believe so. Maybe sausage, but that's it. Biko 2.0, right? I'm trying a different technique too. I'm trying not to stir it like a risotto like last time. Because I'm trying to get more solid bits versus like the almost grit like that I got from the last one. Which was still delicious on its own, but you know, if we can try to improve it, why not, right? You could kind of see the bits are starting to form. And you can see that I've got oil separating from it. Physics. Pierogies? Oh, I really want to. I guess I've had those before. Press it like tofu? Ooh, actually, I don't know. The thing is, I need to get it toasted. So I don't know if I'm gonna, I don't know if it's just the kind of coconut cream I bought. Or if it's because I keep stirring it. So, and I did keep stirring it. Maybe next time I should just let it sit. But I'm like kind of at the same place where I was yesterday. And that's okay. It's not a bad thing. You can see how brown a lot of it's turning. It's fantastic. It smells really good. Toasted coconut, man. One of my favorite smells. I know, physics, thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah, I'm close. Countdown to 1K, guys. It's been a crazy 3 months. Almost 4 months now. Alright, it's starting to get nice and toasty here. Yogurt! EO! What's going on, dude? How you doing? Autosave! Thank you for the follow, dude. Welcome to the Hunger Service. I hope you enjoy your stay here. At the kitchen. In the kitchen. Wherever the kitchen is. And I hope you find some sort of inspiration to cook here at the Hunger Service. Alright. I think we're toasted enough. I don't want to burn it, so I'm going to shut this off. I'm going to strain it. I'm going to move this now. So we're just going to pour that into here. To drain our toasted coconut bits here. Can you see that? It's our toasted coconut. Well, thank you, physics. I do appreciate it. Alright, so I'm just gonna let this sit here. Next up, I need a cup and a half of glutinous rice. Bic lighters! Thanks for the follow, dude. Alright, so. Stewed lentils? Ooh, yeah. But how are you doing, Yogurt? Alright, so I need a cup and a half of glutinous rice. If you're not familiar with glutinous rice, it's kind of short-grained. Sometimes they call it sweet rice. Anyway, we're gonna do a cup and a half here. Thank you, physics. Thank you for bringing him over. I do appreciate it. Okay, so we're gonna rinse this. We're gonna combine a can of coconut milk and a cup of water into this pan until it, begins to cook and thicken up. I'm gonna go ahead and rinse this pan real quick. Wash my rice. So, a cup of water. Alright. What are we seeing here? Cup of water. I'm gonna do our glutinous rice here. I'm gonna grab a cup or a can of coconut milk. We're just gonna cook this. Whole slumber party. Digital art, Yogur. Like, what kind of digital art? Like painting or? Like landscapes? I forgot to shake this. I knew it. Okay. Okay, so. I'm gonna mix this. I've got it on medium high right now. So I know it's not much to look at right now, but it's going to cook, and this rice is gonna get fluffy. It's gonna look fantastic. We're gonna add brown sugar to it and give it a nice color to it. I think I may have put in a bit of toasted coconut in here. Got it. Oh no, it's just a errant grain of rice. Anyway, so we're gonna let this cook down. And we're gonna see Patrick Raw. Oh, Patrick Raw. What's up, dude? Thank you. And Tens, hello. It's a white puddle right now, I know. It's so enticing right now. That's why. I'm going to just do this for you for now. Ooh, there it is. That's our first dish for today. And that's my face. And that's more stuff. My name is Patrick, how dare you? Right now it's a white puddle. But I already cooked dinner. Cooking dessert. Kind of flip-flopped here. You smell upstairs? Good. Alright, so we're mixing it because we don't want it to stick to the bottom. It's like kind of like you gotta treat it like a risotto, right? You don't want it to burn on the bottom. Yeah, ask Alicia. Alicia can help. Actually, she's on right now. You should stop by and say hello. So I'm gonna probably need another maybe cup and a half of water just so I cook this down correctly. Oh, Bella, hello! Hi, Bella. How are you? But hi, Bella. How's it going? Well, just making some some more Filipino dessert. My dad's in town. And my mom sent him up here with food. And my mom makes this all the time, but I feel like she'd appreciate it if I made her some. So I'm making her some right now. Trying to be a good son. My mom lives 3.5 hours away from here in South Florida, so. So you can kind of see the rice underneath this slowly starting to puff up. So I'm just like sweeping my spatula underneath, making sure the rice at the bottom doesn't overcook or burn and stick to the bottom. Hey Trixie, how are you? I heard you all were having a rough night on Overwatch the other night. Are you excited for the new event? I really want to get my hands on like a bunch of skins. And Tommy, what's going on? Oh, seriously, Trixie? I bet everyone's just trying to blitz and get to the... All the good players are playing it right now because they're all trying to push their ranks higher before the season ends. It's okay, Trixie, I believe in you. You can do it. All right. I'm gonna add another half cup of water here. So we need to cook this rice all the way through. You can kind of see it puffing up very slowly. Oh man. You went from 1890 all the way down to 900? Oh my gosh. Who do you main again, Trixie? D.Va, right? You main D.Va, right? Yeah, D.Va's rough. Unless you have like dedicated, really good dedicated healers, D.Va's rough to play in solo queue. Because the Ana I play with is really freaking good. So whenever I dive, like, he's got me healed through most of it. Now I'm gonna test it. Let's take a spoon here off. Doesn't look cooked enough yet, but I may as well check. Oh, yeah. Not ready yet. Can you hear the cooking noises, by the way? That's what I'm curious about. I'm not sure if the mic's picking it up at all. They were all close. Oh, the worst. Sweaty games, man. Oh. Like, if I play a sweaty game, I'm like, alright, I need a break. So what we're doing is we're cooking the water and the coconut milk into the rice. And that's why it takes a while. Add another half cup of water here. But the rice is slowly coming up. Okay, good. As long as you guys can hear that. Because I was worried that this mic wasn't going to catch any of that. No, you spelled it right. But thank you, Zombie Hunter and Trixie, for letting me know about the mic. Yeah, lumpia. Lumpia is like one of the gateway Filipino dishes, I feel like. It's innocuous enough to be like, ooh, let me try that. And then that's when you go off the deep end to other Filipino food. Almost there. Starting to get nice and soft. Oh, yeah. Where are you located again, Trixie? If you don't mind me asking. There's a few places in South Florida, or a few families really, that cook for like cater and stuff.
It's pretty cool.
Alright, we're gonna, from here, we're gonna add a cup of brown sugar. I'll turn that down a little bit. You lost all your matches today too, Yoger? No. Yeah, it's rough at the end of the season. I think it's rough at the beginning and the end of the season. Everyone kind of falls off in the middle. But beginning and the end, everyone's just trying to rush. Good luck to you guys. I think right now I'm 2670. It's been interesting. I've ranked gold the last three seasons. This is the first season I'm plat. But I don't feel like I play like a plat. I think I'm gonna add a little more water. This could use a little more cook time. Next yogurt, yo, when I'm done here, first thing I'm gonna do is like dive into the arcade and try and get as many loot boxes as I can. Cause I really like that graffiti tracer. I want May's dance because it's Haruhi's dance, if you're familiar with that anime. Wait, what movie, Anna? Now I'm intrigued as to which movie this is, Anna. Mama Boy? What the heck? Never even heard of it. Never heard of that before. Okay. My rice is cooked. Well, we have to cook this down further so that it thickens up. I'm gonna let it sit and just simmer. I'm gonna prep my pans here. I'm not sure if I need both. I'll probably need both, considering the size. Ooh, I'm gonna calm that down. What the heck? That's on like an early 2000s premise movie. Maybe late 90s. It's a 2017 movie? What the heck? Is it following the trend of like crazy movies like Sharknado? Or is it like a legit comedy movie that came out like that they were trying to make have it be like a semi-serious? Yeah, this is a legit comedy movie, guys. Not like a ironically funny, like Sharknado. Gary Busey. Now I know it's crazy. For sure. Yikes. I really should move that more. Or I should pull this back toward me so I'm not like leaning on the counter so much. Inchon? What's it about, zombie? We're slowly evaporating any sort of water because we want it to get nice and thick for our pan here. War movie? So what was bad about it? Isn't Gary Busey like kind of insane already? I'm not crazy for thinking that, right? Or is it just because of all the memes of Gary Busey? He is definitely insane. I agree with Anna. Zombie, you should totally watch it. I'm gonna look it up after this. I have a hard time sitting through movies. Mainly because I get bored in the middle of them. Like, I always feel like I should be doing something else while I'm watching a movie. Unless I'm really into the movie or as is, but not a lot of movies get me to that point. Almost there. It's starting to pull away altogether, little by little. I spread a little bit of coconut oil in here. I'm not sure how much this is gonna fill up that. I'm sure it's gonna go over. So I'm trying to figure out a secondary pan for it. I don't want to waste two of them. I guess I'll just use this one. So I've got a glass one here too that I'm gonna prep just in case. Mama boy. Oh, there we go. It's getting to a nice darker brown color now. I use light brown sugar, but I feel like darker brown sugar would give it a nicer, deeper brown tone. What other bad movies have you guys seen? I know everyone talks about the Mario Brothers movie, like it's a really bad movie, but I don't know if it's just I have nostalgia, you know, like rose-tinted glasses about it. But I didn't think it was that bad. Or the Ninja Turtle movies. Okay, I think we're good here. I kind of want to keep going for this, but I'm not sure. I mean, I've already made this once, but maybe I can go further, make sure it's even thicker than last time. all the crumbs, Anna. Alright, I'm gonna get myself in the mode here for later. Cause we're gonna... I'm gonna play this. Wait, no, that's not it. Napoleon Dynamite? You know, honestly, I'm in that same boat about Napoleon Dynamite. Except I never caught the awkward humor makes me cringe. Like, I'm just like, oh, why are you so awkward? Stop. Stop. Oh, I can't deal with it. All right, we're good here. You're the same way. Glad I'm not the only one. I'm already awkward enough as is. On my own. I don't need more of it. Alright, I'm gonna pour this into this pan. I'm gonna see how far I can get without it freaking out here. All right, I think that's good. All right. You hide everything from it? Yeah, I feel that. Alright. I think that's enough for that. I think the pan I prepared for the extra is a little too wide, so I'm gonna just prep this Pyrex here for the leftovers. I don't want it to stick, so I'm putting the coconut oil on it. And then we're just gonna pour this into here. There you go, that's good. Still a little bit on the wide side, but it's okay. All right. Far too epic for this music's far too epic for what I'm doing right now. But if you guys are playing Overwatch, it's Overwatch's anniversary today. And I'm gonna be partaking in that later. So I'm just layering my toasted coconut bits here on top. Not being very stingy with it. Just putting as much of it as I can on here.
Yeah, for sure it'll thicken as it cools, zombie. It'll thicken up and then you can cut it into like bars and serve it. And then you could use more of this coconut bit. These coconut bits to top it off. But this is the, I'm keeping this one because that's the only one that fits there. Or that's all that fits over there. So yeah. This is mine, and that's the one I'm sending away. Totally, actually here, guys. That's me. That's my Battle.net. Add me, and then when you add me, after you add me, send me a DM or a whisper telling me who you are. Cool. Thanks, Anna. Okay, so that's our dessert. Not many ingredients. It's amazing when it's nice and warm, like it is right now. But I'm not gonna eat this one. It is not for me. It is for my parents who are in town. These, neither of these fit this. I spent like the last like 2 minutes trying to close it. I guess I'll just spoil it. Oh well. Alright, well, that's it for today. I think I'm just gonna have a spoon of this here so I don't ruin this one. But it should solidify. Not really solidify, it should stick all together. And it's fantastic when it's warm. It's like really creamy, nice and sweet. And then you get like coconut bits on top. Has a nice kind of adds a little bit of texture. Mm. So you want a simple like sticky rice dish? This is easy. Easy mode. Okay. All right, guys. Well, thanks for hanging out today. I know it was a long one, but I was just gonna cook and make random things today. So that was fun. Oh, there we go. Toasted coconut bits on top of sweetened coconut sticky rice. Really a simple Filipino dessert. Worth a try. Alright, so we're gonna go over. I'm gonna send you guys over to. Let's see, is she on? Is she on? Yes. She is on. I'm gonna send you over to Alicia. If you're not familiar with Alicia, she also plays Overwatch. She's a creator streamer. She's my girlfriend. So I'm gonna send you over to her. So we're gonna do the recall. If you're not familiar with her, you will be. She was here. I don't think she came down here earlier, but she's pops in the stream every so often. You know who she is. But yeah, I will see you guys over there. Take care. I'll see you tomorrow at 6 p.m. We're making okonomiyaki. And yeah. I'm going to start playing Overwatch in a bit. But yeah, I'll see you guys over there. So copy the right message, drop it in your chat, and say hello. Thanks again, guys, for hanging out. Zombie, Yogurt, Anna, and everyone else that's in here. Thanks again. See you later. Bye, Allure.